me, Busty.
Okay.
Did you actually record any songs with Teddy Riley during that period?
Well, I recorded a lot of stuff because, see, I was there as a staff writer as well as an artist. So a lot of the stuff that I recorded, you heard it. It was on the Black Street album. I did background vocals. I wrote, you know what I mean? But not for my album, no. I recorded, I believe, one song called Before We Kiss Goodnight, which is a song that Pharrell wrote for me. You know, and, you know, of course, Shad played on it, but, you know, after we got to know each other and he got to know my personality and stuff like that, we started hanging out and being friends. He wrote that song for me, you know, to be, like, one of the songs on the album. Teddy heard it, Teddy loved it. As a matter of fact, when I mean, it wasn't mommy saying this, but when I think back, he was very impressed with the song because I don't know if he knew that the Neptunes really had all of that, what they had in them, you know. It was, like, had, like, a jazzy type of feel to it, and it wasn't, like, you know, it wasn't like kiddie pop stuff, you know what I'm saying? It was more, you know, and I remember him hearing it. I'll never forget it, like it was yesterday when he heard it. He was like, that's really nice, but then, come on, let's do the album. Let's go, you know, and I don't know, you know, sometimes I think that Teddy became a little bit, I don't know if you want to call it intimidated or whatever, because Pharrell was a new guy. He was young. He had a lot of ideas. You know, still to this day, that's one thing I love about that boy. That boy got ideas coming out of his ears, you know, constantly. And he was always, you know, and he had time to work with me, and Teddy didn't. And that's how we hooked up so good, because Teddy was so preoccupied. He didn't have time for me, for the Neptune, and except as he needed us to, you know, to work on something. He would say, Tam, come in and have a song for you. Take this track, write to it, come back, you know, set down the vocals, whatever the case was. And then, you know, but he was, listen, he was busy with his own stardom.
And you recorded, co-wrote a track called Joy, which ended up on Blackstreet's album.
Right.
And when I was looking at the credits on that, it was kind of odd because it was, you know, yourself, Tammy Lucas, Teddy Riley, and Michael Jackson.
Right.
So was that meant to be a track on Michael's album?
Yeah, that was for the Dangerous album. Teddy was working with Michael on that, and during that time, they had recorded and written so many songs. You know how Michael is, you know? So I was just, you know, listen, Michael Jackson was it for me. Before I even heard of Chaka Khan, it was Michael Jackson for me, you know? And he was it for me. I mean, that was one of the biggest things that ever happened to me. And even though he didn't do the song, I just feel so proud that I had worked with him because, you know, he's a guy that really knows what the heck he's doing with this music thing, you know. And it didn't go on the album. That was the bottom line. It was just one of the many songs that we had written and recorded and everything. And they didn't choose it to go on the album. But Michael had actually did the melody to the song. That's why it sounds like him. I wrote the lyrics. You know, of course, Teddy did the track, you know, and I did some of the arrangement, and, you know, he recorded it, but, you know.
So how many tracks did, were meant to be on, with run for the Dangerous album, which never actually came out?
Oh, I couldn't even count, because to tell you the truth, I wasn't there during every time they recorded, you know. I'm only privy to the stuff that I did with Teddy, which I worked on, Remember the Time, me, Bernard Bell, Teddy Riley. We worked on Remember the Time, Joy, and I want to say another song. And I believe that Bernard Bell ended up, you know, he's the one that wrote Remember the Time with Teddy, you know. He just had us, you know, all writing on it.
So, hold on, you wrote Remember the Time, but you weren't credited for it?
No, I didn't write it. What, you know what it is that, like, when they had the tracks, open tracks, Teddy flew us down to L.A. because we recorded it. I think they were at Larrabee Studios at the time. He flew us down, and how we worked was is how I work, you know. He just gives me the song. I go back, you know, to my hotel room, if I was home in my home, and I write down, put down all my ideas, what I want, put down melodies, lyrics, and that's what Bernard Bell also did, separate. And then we come back to the studio, play both of our ideas, and then they choose what they liked and what they didn't like. So they didn't like the stuff that I had written for Remember the Time. So it was never chosen. It was, you know, it's not on. The stuff that you hear is, I didn't write it. That's the thing.
Sure.
They got me for the other one.
So then at that point, I'd like to say 94, 95 time, you left the Teddy Riley camp and you were closely linked with the Neptunes, Pharrell and Chad.
Right.
That was because of the relationship you'd built up beforehand.
Right.
So you were working on a lot of stuff with them, right?
Yeah. After we met them there in Virginia, you know, Teddy was stationed in Virginia Beach. That's how we met them. Their school was right next to the studio. I mean, what luck, huh?
Yeah.
Especially for Pharrell and Chad. I mean, you know, I mean, I came from Harlem, you know, from New York there. But what luck for those guys. But in any case, like I said, being that we had a lot of time on our hands, you know, Teddy was so busy, he was traveling, he was doing this, you know, whatever. And so during that time, you know, I had my own place. And we just wrote, we got together. And once we became friends, Pharrell was like, you know, that's one thing I love about that boy. He is like, okay, we're working every day. I'm coming over. What are you doing? Come on, let's go. We're going to Chad's. Because Chad had some equipment at his house. It was so funny. I mean, these are like the best times, you know. And we would just pack up. They would come and get me because I didn't have a car. I didn't drive, you know. Come get me. Go to Chad's house. Work there all day. And his work ethic is ridiculous because that boy must have known he was going to, you know, be what he is today, because he just started working like, this is what I do. He was so serious about it, you know, and we did that for like 4 years, you know, off and on. And even after I parted from Teddy, I still stayed in Virginia because I was linked with the Neptune. So I stayed there even afterwards, you know.
Sure.
I had already left Future. And they had left Future, you know, over that Rum Shaker song, because Pharrell did the...
He wrote the rap for
right,
Teddy.
Right, and then Teddy, the paperwork, the money work, whatever, that wasn't right. That's what's always the issue, you know what I'm saying? It's either that or people don't want to give you a rights or whatever the case is, you know. And I guess he felt, I'm, you know, the guy that's established already. You're a nobody. Not in those words, but you know what I'm saying. You're a new person, and, you know, but still, I never felt that way. And I never treated them that way, even though I was already known when we wrote. Whatever we wrote, equal credit. I didn't make it up. Why should, what difference does it make that I am more famous than you or already established? What the hell does that have to do with it? You know what I mean? Listen, let me tell you something. You can meet somebody and not know them and they may have mad talent, okay? That's their talent. They should get their money. They should get their credit. And, you know, that's one thing I think that people like about me in this business, the people that know me. I don't mess around with all that, you know. You take your credit, I'll take mine, and, you know, and that's really, that's why Pharrell left, because once he realized that Teddy thought that he, you know, it was owed to him, and whatever the case was, and it just came to a head where he said, well, either, you know, you're not happy, and just go, and I think he let them out of their deal. And then I left a little while after that, and we just began to work on a lot of stuff. Kenny Ortiz is a guy that I know from the Hey Boy days. I met him, my first deal that I was offered, you know, when I was working with Boy Jarvis and Timmy Regisford. I know Kenny from back then. So he came back into the picture because of SWV also.
He did Right Here, right? The remix.
Exactly.
That was his idea.
The whole thing was his idea. And he had brought Pharrell in on that SWV because he did like a little rap.
Yeah.
Then later on, once we officially left, you know, from Teddy, we began to write songs for SWV, for Tamia. You know, Kenny was like a manager for us, not officially, but you know what I mean. And going out and taking songs and trying to get us work and stuff like that. And he had gotten us an EMI compilation deal. We're going to do that. It seemed good. And then we had gotten the money and everything. We got the money to record. We were recording. You know, we got our advances, this, that, and the other. And then the company folded like a year after that.
Wow.
Yeah, so.